We've now covered all the uniform polyhedra. So to wrap up this topic, this video presents a chart summarising all the different categories of uniform polyhedra and their duals. Most of these categories are covered in detail in separate videos. I have posted a high-definition image of the chart if you want to download it. Please see the description below for details. The chart is broadly divided into convex figures at the top and non-convex figures at the bottom, but also between prismatic shapes on the left and the shapes with 3D symmetry on the right. The prismatic shapes are the infinite families of prisms and antiprisms. The convex prisms are simple shapes, but their non-convex cousins are more complex. Antiprisms are similar, but with triangles instead of squares. Non-convex antiprisms also come in a third variety, the crossed antiprism, which has backward-facing faces. Moving across to the polyhedra with three-dimensional symmetry, we start with the regular polyhedra, which are the convex Platonic solids and the non-convex Kepler-Poinsot polyhedra. The quasi-regular polyhedra have identical edges as well as identical vertices. The 13 convex non-regular solids as a whole are known as the Archimedean solids. One interesting subcategory of these is the snub polyhedra. There are only two convex snubs, both of which are chiral, not mirror symmetric, but there are many more non-convex snubs, several of which do have mirror symmetry. 11 of the non-convex polyhedra are hemipolyhedra, having faces that pass through the centre. 9 of these are quasi-regular. Miller's monster is the most complicated uniform polyhedron. It has many characteristics of snub polyhedra, so I've included it in the snub section. And Skilling's figure has 4 faces meeting at some edges, so it isn't technically a valid polyhedron, but it is so famous I've included it in the chart in grey. There are 9 Archimedean solids that don't fit into any particular subcategory, and no less than 29 non-convex polyhedra outside the subcategories. Now, if we construct a large sphere around the chart, we can invert it to create a chart of uniform duals. The bipyramids are the duals of the prisms, and the trapezohedra are the duals of the antiprisms. Crossed trapezohedra also exist. The dual of each regular polyhedron is another regular polyhedron, so this section as a whole remains the same. The quasi-regular duals have identical edges as well as identical faces. The Catalan solids are the duals of the Archimedean solids. Dual snubs are chiral if the corresponding uniform polyhedron is chiral. The hemipolyhedra do not have duals in Euclidean space. The closest representations are the Wenninger duals, which I've shown in grey. Likewise, the dual of Miller's monster is another Wenninger dual, and the dual of Skilling's figure is also a Wenninger dual. And finally, the 9 Catalan solids that don't fit into any particular subcategory, and the 29 remaining non-convex duals. As always, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.